In randomized experiments, we knew that treatment was randomly assigned because we did the randomization ourselves, or maybe someone we trusted did it. So with the unconfoundedness assumption, however, we have to assume that treatment is randomly assigned once we control for certain covariates. So the real critical question here is that assumption correct? Is it credible? Do we believe it? Is treatment really randomly assigned once we look at people with the same values of a certain list of covariates? Well, typically it's pretty hard to argue that this is true, because you have to argue that you've got the exact correct set of covariates that you've controlled for. And how do you know that you haven't forgotten one of them? Maybe you haven't even measured them all correctly. Usually it's pretty easy for researchers to think of additional covariates that you could have measured, that you didn't include in your analysis, and that might confound things, that might be a reason to expect that treatment is not randomly assigned, conditional on some covariates. And people might disagree on whether these variables that you think up are important, but the basic problem is if you don't measure them, then you have no idea if they're important or not. So for these reasons, people are often pretty skeptical of claims about causality based solely on the unconfoundedness assumption. And beyond just this unconfoundedness assumption, there are a lot of other statistical assumptions that are used in the methods as well, like how exactly you do the matching. And basically the reason is because of the nature of the problem, you can't just do a simple mean comparison like you'd do in a randomized experiment. You have to do these mean comparisons within groups, or you have to match people like we discussed in a previous module. And when you do this, you have to make some additional assumptions. Now, it's often pretty easy to get caught up in exactly how you do the matching, and people argue about this all the time, about the statistical methods for doing this. But at the end of the day, all of these technical things aside, they all rely on one thing, the unconfoundedness assumption. So whether you believe your analysis with your causal claims or not depends on whether you believe that assumption. So I may sound pretty negative about unconfoundedness, and you may think, I should never use it. Why are we even talking about using regression as a causal inference method? Well, partly that's correct. And in later modules, we'll talk about other methods that are a little more credible than regression as causality. But in other cases, you can't use these other methods. And you can't always do an experiment for every policy you want to know its effect of. So what can you do instead? Well, sometimes doing a regression-based analysis or using matching and making the unconfoundedness assumption is really all you can do.